Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is apps and Power BI services. Let us directly jump into Microsoft definition of app. An app is a Power BI content type that combines related dashboard and reports in all in one place. So it is self-explanatory, like it gathers different reports and dashboards created by you in a single content type, or it can be a container. You can call it as a container. So an app can have one or more dashboards and one or more reports all bundled together. It is same as the previous one. And apps are created by Power BI designers who distribute and share the app with their colleagues. So basically, someone who created the reports and they want to find a very good way to share the reports that are related to each other. So instead of sharing different URLs for different reports, they can bundle all the related reports in a single place called app, and then they can share the app URL to them. So people always go to the app and see whatever reports they are allowed to access to, then they can interact with that. That is the whole idea behind app. Let us try to check in this video as a demo how to create an app. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button to learn the concepts in Power BI. Now we are in Power BI services, where you can see the My Workspace. This is your personal container or sandbox, where you do not have any options to create data flows or data sets, or what you can see. Like, I mean, data flows are not available, and even the Power BI apps are not able to create it, right? So where you have to go, that is basically the content workspace that you have created in, where you can able to create data flows using a pro user. Similarly, here you can have an option to create an app. So what it does now, let us try to understand it, what I'm trying to say. Let us see it in a lineage view. Now you have these many reports, 1, 2, 3, and you have see a dashboard created here with these three reports, and then you have report for loan disbursement. So that's it. So four reports and one dashboard. So you maybe it can be many. Okay, so you want to share only these two reports and this dashboard along with this. I do not want to share this one as a sales performance report. So for that, this has to be shared to some 100 plus users or whoever. So what you can do is, instead of giving him the Power BI access, they don't want to log in and see this Power BI reports, something like whatever I'm trying to say is, when they launch using Power BI and they can see like that, they want to navigate to report or dashboard, they want to see this such a thing. Instead of doing them like this, give them app like behavior, something trying to launch into app, they see the reports, then come back. It's end user reporting layer, right? How we can create, just do one app, then we'll see how it looks like. For that, create an app, then give a name as sales performance or sales performance, something like that, whatever. Or I will say AWN, analytics with Nags sales performance, and go for it. Then just provide the summary to monitor the sales, right? Bear with me, I'm very poor in writing. Monitor in sales, that's okay. So you can have the, some support site if you want. You can change the logo if you want and check the color. Let us go for hello. Then show app publisher, who is the publisher of this app. Show item context from this workspace. You want to go for it, go for it. Just I will go for the default option. Then go for navigation. This is the main part, where you have all the dashboards and reports listed over here. You see this sales performance monitor is your dashboard, and whether you want to show this one or not. I just want to hide the two reports, loan disbursement and sales executive. This should not be shown. So just we will say sales performance, sales analysis, sales reasonable sales. So these three reports to be shown at the end, right? So what it can have, so dashboard details, if you want to change, you can change it here, and anything if you want to change, you can change it here, right? Then you have to choose the permission. So here we have hidden whatever we should not show as part of this app, and permission, you want to give it to entire organization, you can give it. And if you want to restrict to some users, you can choose from your list of users, and then you can go for it. This is also fine, right? That's it. So basically you can give to some specific user to give access to view this app. Users and group with access to this workspace can access this app. So who can access? So they should have access to this workspace as well. Okay, this executive dashboard. This is fine. Then check other options here. Allow all users to connect to the app's underlying data sets using build permission. Whether you want to give them a build permission or not, if your user is not going to be a developer, they want to be only the business user, just see the report, then uncheck it, then go for publish app. So it says a warning, the content will be available within 5 to 10 minutes, but it will take up to 1 day. It says just it will take some time, but I hope it will be fine, successfully published. Then copy this URL and then share this URL to your end user, so that they, once you put this app in a new window, just they will see it as a app, right? You can see here, it's just looking like one website. They don't bother about what is data set, data views, just like that. They just log in and directly see the reports instead of launching, clicking on the report, going back and like that. So you can hide it here so that you can see the full view of it. Even once it is published, right? So you can go to the apps, but whatever you have published here, it will appear here. You can launch it. This is the whoever developed and whoever has the access to this workspace. Then for them, it will appear here. We gave access to two of the users. For those two users, this will appear. So they can comment whatever rights they have, they can do here, and then they can develop it. So this is basically about apps where user can navigate. They don't want to understand more about Power BI and all. Just for a business user, end user, you can use this option. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.